pound bronze medal match here at the South Point Hotel and Resort in Las Vegas, south end of the Strip, and this will be Mexico against the United States as Christy Collin takes the stage along with Linda Ochoa from Mexico, Christy Collin of the United States on your right, defeating Great Britain's Nicola Simpson, the grandmother, 56 years of age, defeated her in the quarterfinals 6-2, and then was defeated herself in the semis 6-4 by Inga van Caspel of the Netherlands. So Christy Collin ranked 9th in the world. And of course, she improved her world ranking by winning the silver medal at the World Cup Finals last September in Istanbul. There's a good look at Linda Ochoa from Mexico, who got past Pascal Lebec of France in a quarterfinal match, 6-2. Her semifinal matchup with Victoria Balzanova went to a shootout. They both fired 10s, but Ochoa's was furthest from the middle, so she ends up in this bronze medal match against Christy Collins. So two veterans, two very good archers.
Yeah, these are two very big names in terms of women's combat archery. This should be a terrific match. And for those of you who weren't here earlier, you may notice that the target faces, the 10 ring looks a heck of a lot smaller for these people. The compound 10 ring is quite a bit smaller than that for the recurve 10. This one's only 2 centimeters across, roughly the size of a penny.
Of course, when you're shooting from 18 meters instead of 50 meters, which you do outdoors,
opening arrow for
there has to be some compensation made, and the opening arrow is a 9 for Christy Collin.
Nine
for Linda Ochoa,
who is ranked 18th in the world, was as high as 6th back in April of last year.
Nice shot, Christy.
So Christy Collin making a statement with that shot, taking a bit of a lead. Ochoa can match her with a 10 of her own.
Whose eyes match her bow, match her country's green shirt.
9.
That's an interesting strategy. I think that's the first archer I've seen shoot top, bottom, then center. Again, it doesn't matter which order you shoot these target faces in, as long as you've got one arrow in each. That's the first
shot
set for Christy Collin.
Now again, about how big is that right there, that center ring?
That's 2 centimeters across, roughly the size of a penny. And you're looking at it from the other side of a basketball.
As you said earlier, about 20 yards away.
20 yards.
18 meters, 20 yards. But both fire a 10 on their final shot. But Von Collin with 29 points to 28 for Linda Ochoa. So she wins the set by 1 point and picks up 2 set points in doing so.
And this is different. The compound category outdoors, they shoot 15 arrows for cumulative scores. So the indoor elimination round for compound is actually quite different from their outdoor round. For those knowledgeable archers who are watching out there wondering what we're talking about set play for.
Good look at the Easton arrows, the knocks on those Easton arrows. Fletching. Christy Collin of the United States.
Won
2 team gold medals at stage 3 of the World Cup in Ogden last year. 2 team gold medals at stage 3 in Antalya. Gold medal in the mixed team competition at the first stage in Croatia. She had a total of 7 World Cup medals last summer.
Well, that's an acceptable showing, I would say.
I would say so. And when you throw in the gold medal that she won with her team in Torino at the World Championships, pretty good year.
Yes.
Scores are official and on the board. Linda Ochoa of Mexico shooting first.
In fact, it wasn't a pretty good year. It was a great year.
I take it for sure.
So Ochoa trailing 2-0 in set points.
Starts out the second set.
Tienes 10, Titi. 7.
9.
It's interesting. When she's coming over the peak of the cam, she seems to jerk back into full draw, almost as if she's a little bit overbowed.
Trabájame bien esas dos.
It might be that she's got a really aggressive cam on her bows there.
9.
But what you like to see is a really nice, smooth draw with no real jerking action to it. It's an onto her trigger nice and gently, squeezes it off.
That works.
Ese es tu disparo.
That's solid, perfect on that shot for Linda Ochoa of Mexico. Christy Collin with that elbow up high with another nine.
Strong shot.
So now Linda Ochoa has the opportunity to take the. You see there that.
Esa es la que te gusta,
to me, it looks a little uncomfortable. I guess she's quite familiar with it. I'm sure she practices 5-7 times a week, 120. 160 euros a day.
Nine.
So I'm sure she's used to it.
Now with that nine,
she's a little uneasy.
She presents an opportunity for Christy Collin, who can salvage this with a 10.
Well, but at best, Christy can split the end.
Exactly. But at least come away with some.
Absolutely. It won't be necessarily a draw. That was a long hole.
Can't do it.
Christy Collin, I think, will start out the next set.
I
think both of these women will be happy to know that their cumulative score won't be recorded.
That is the beauty of the set system.
This is this compound target, which only has the compound 10 ring. This is the first time I've seen it, so I don't know how often these two archers have seen it. It's fairly new. The older targets had both the recurve 10 and the compound 10 on them. So some of the compound archers have been saying that they've had to refine their aiming mechanisms. Like they used to have a small dot in the center of their scope that they would center in the recurve 10. So they knew where they were, but now without that recurve 10 as a reference, they're
having to learn how to hit this
little 10 again.
Well, the target
has
shrunk even more.
No, it hasn't shrunk. It's exactly the same size target that they had before. It just used to be that the recurve 10 was there as a reference.
Oh, I see.
Now they don't have that.
Okay. So we're tied up at 2.
Yeah, and Christy should shoot first in this set.
We should first.
Christy had 2 10s in her first set.
Christy.
3 9s in her second set. And the first shot of the third set.
10.
It is a 10.
Nice shot, babe.
Yeah, that's good shooting by Christy. She's got a nice general group. She doesn't. All of her arrows aren't tending to one side or the other. There might be a tiny bit left, in general. And the same thing with Linda.
Es
here. Couple arrows high, couple arrows low, a few arrows right in the middle. Both of them have their sights set perfectly.
10.
A 10 for both archers on their first shot. Collin with her second shot. Under 5 seconds to go, and she lets it fly, and it's a 9.
Yeah, that clock is it's a deceptively interesting thing, because it doesn't matter if you have a half a second left on the clock when that arrow goes.
But it still plays on your mind when you know it's counting down.
Yep.
Look into the eyes of Linda Ochoa. She eyes a 10.
Come on, Christy. Strong shot.
Bien corregido. Muy bien.
Looking down the shaft of that arrow.
10.
Now Christy Collin's about
nine.
To fire, and she fires a 9.
Great opportunity for Linda to take the lead in this match for the first time.
Es tu cara,
Christy
tu lesa.
Not terribly pleased with herself, I think. All she needs is a 9.
This is the first time all day that Ochoa has shot. She was not in the team competition this morning.
A lot of movement on her hand on that release. That was not a good shot at all.
But she still wins the set by 1 point.
Yep.
And picks up 2 set points.
Yeah, you can see, even from the camera angle we had, you could see her string hand dropping and her fingers coming around on her release, as opposed to just staying rock solid as the action of her elbow brings the trigger through her thumb and the release goes. That was a struggle. It's interesting how, when all of a sudden all you have to do is hit the gold, how small that gold gets.
So Linda Ochoa up 4-2 in the match after 3 sets, going to the 4th set right now. Ochoa, 2 gold medals at the 2010 Pan Am Championships, and a member of the gold medal mixed team in 2010 in Shanghai, where she also won a silver medal in the individual competition. Picked up a silver medal in the individual competition at Stage 4 in Shanghai last fall. So Ochoa.
Very, very strong shooter from Mexico. From a big shooting family, Ruben Ochoa.
Okay, Christy, strong shot this time.
Another great shooter.
Kristy Collin with her work cut out for her right here, trying to get back into the match. Needs to win this set to tie it up at four apiece. That's a good start.
Nice shot. Yep.
Nice shot. That's a nice 10.
Fuerte izquierdo, Titi. Fuerte.
Both coaches giving basically the same advice. Strong shot.
Yeah.
Both archers giving
bien,
them 10.
Bien.
Seems like good advice, I guess.
Strong shot. Ten.
A little bit of a tremble.
Five.
And again, that bowhand not supposed to be moving at all, right?
Ten, nine,
but we'll look at the result.
That's a good shot. It's a little bit low. Might want to give her sight just a tiny little tick down.
They'll put an asterisk by it.
Oh, you can see how, see the rust on that arrow rest screw there. That's a bow that's well used out there.
Yeah,
Kristy, strong shot this time. Come on.
So we may be tied and we may not be tied here in this set.
There's a lot of close arrows.
Ten.
There's a good 10.
Nice shot.
No doubt about that one.
So Linda really does need a 10 on this one.
Just to make sure.
Just to make sure that they at least split the points. If they, you know, with the lead, she'll still be safe. Right? Kristy has put herself in a good position. That's a solid 10. So Linda may have won.
We'll see.
But I don't think so. I think it'll be 5.
All right. So nobody move. Stay right where you are. We're going to have to wait and see whether that 9 is a 9 or if it's a 10. And it will make a world of difference. It could determine the match. The match could be over right now. We just don't know it. It's 4-2 at this point in favor of Ochoa.
Unofficially, it's 6-2, which would mean the match is over, but that's only unofficial. We have to wait for the judges to confirm that low arrow, which they're taking a good look at now. And having a second look at it, I'm actually not so certain. It might
they gave her a 29. I believe they gave her a 29.
They've just confirmed.
It's good, it's good.
Oh, it's good. So that's a 10.
Yeah. Oh, it is a 10.
That is a 10. All right. Split set.
All right.
So they'll have to change that on the score sheet.
Okay.
Yep, they'll get rid of that.
All right, so it's three 10s in that set for Kristy Collin. Three 10s for Linda Ochoa. They split it.
That was spectacular shooting.
Tremendous shooting. Under the gun, under pressure right now. And so instead of a 6-2 victory, we continue on. And we go to the fifth set. As Kristy breaks a smile. And, nervous smile.
Three strong
I think.
Ones, all right.
So Linda still has that little bit of a cushion. She doesn't need to win the set. A tie will still get her to win this match. And
three good ones, three good ones.
Even
okay.
A loss will just lead to a shootout. So Linda's got a little bit of cushion, a little bit of cushion of safety. It'll be interesting to see what happens.
Got a little room to play with.
Come on,
no margin for error for Kristy Collin, who trails in the match 5-3.
Yeah, this is a must-win
nine.
Situation for Kristy. And that
fuerte
nine,
izquierdo,
it's not the end of the world, but it's not what you're looking for.
En esa.
Same spot with that target.
Bien, bien, Titi, bien, Titi.
High.
All right, this is you, this is you. Come on, this is you.
I believe they called it a 9. Spotters can probably see it better than we did just there. But the
ten.
Spotters have given it an asterisk.
Five.
Nine.
Ooh, that's a big 9. All those arrows are low left. I stand corrected.
Go faster, okay?
Down a little bit.
Fuerte izquierdo, Titi. Fuerte izquierdo.
Ochoa just needs to be solid from here on out.
Looks like she's nine. Trembling a little bit.
Down the middle, down the middle.
A little nervous, I think.
Can't blame them, can you?
Not at all. That was a good shot.
Nice shot. Nice strong shot. Way to get it off.
Well, if that's to be her last shot of the day, at least she finishes strong with a dead solid perfect 10.
Linda needs a good 10. Good 10 to guarantee the win. A 9, still a possible 10. Oh, there's a good 10. Linda Ochoa is the
lead. She leaves no doubt about it.
Takes the bronze medal.
And you can see the relief coming across the face of Linda Ochoa, who does a great job in this women's compound bronze medal match. A great shootout between Kristy Collin and Linda Ochoa.
Yeah,
but on that final shot, she left no doubt in anybody's mind as she put the match away, wins the 2 points, and winds up winning 7-3.
Yep, she was just shooting arrow for arrow. So all she had to do was keep pace with what Christy was doing, and that's exactly what she did.
La que tenía sacar. Ah, la dieron 9.
So two of the best in the world going at it in the bronze medal match.
Nothing like leaving it to the last arrow, though. You're giving us announcers heart attacks over here.
But providing us with some great entertainment, which Las Vegas is known for. We're glad we're able to share it with you here on YouTube. For those of you.
It is gorgeous to watch. It's so much fun when the matches are close like this.
And we've had some great ones. Jake Kaminsky and Marco Galeazzo.
Valeva. And Miranda Leek. And now Ochoa and Christy Collin. They're fantastic matches. And there's no reason to suspect the next three won't be just as good. This is a great demonstration of how good archery can be to watch.
In fact, really the only lopsided match that we've had thus far was the one between Brady Ellison and Herbert Dornhofer. Three straight sets, and Brady Ellison getting his work done in about, seemed like under 10 minutes.
Yep.
Didn't take much time.
But I think, I'm not sure what...